Ambassador Ashok Sajjanhar joins me on the show. He keeps a hawk eye on developments in China. Nitin Srivastav joins us from Hangzhou. And Nitin, is this India specific, or should this just be seen as Chinese incompetence?
Let's start with the instances that we have seen here in the Hangzhou Asian Games, that what exactly has happened with the Indian athletes here, starting with Jyoti. She was participating in hurdles and she was given bronze medal just because of Chinese athlete who started and given a false start. And later on, when Indian officials and our athlete Jyoti herself objected that decision, then they only gone through and decided to upgrade her medal. That was the very first episode when Chinese officials had given a wrong decision. And another episode when Neeraj, our star Indian athlete, his first throw was not counted. Right after that, the same event, Kishore Jena, who got silver medal of the javelin event, his throw was given foul. There are many more instances. For example, Anu Rani, she got gold medal in the women's javelin category. Her throw was also not counted. So there are many instances, and keeping in mind all those wrong decisions, India was very serious and concerned about all these wrongdoings from the officials of organizing committee of Asian Games. They planned now. This is the high time to raise our objections, and they actually had a word with officials, and they are now planning to lodge an official complaint to the authentic bodies and concerned bodies. So this was something which was, you can say that, I spoke to Anju Babu George, who is the Vice President of Athletics Federation of India. She was categorically saying to India Today that this is something which Chinese officials are doing purposely and intentionally to the Indian athletes. So we are going to take this matter to the right authorities.
Stay with me for a moment, Ambassador. How do you read the Chinese actions? You heard Anju Babu George saying that this is mischief, this is intentional.
Yeah, you know, that is what appears to me from, a prima facie reading of the case. Because, what I understand is we have spoken about four of the Indian athletes who have been wronged, who have been their performance has been sought to be curtailed, whether it's Neeraj Chopra or it's Anu Rani or, Jenna or the other, athlete.
Jyoti, yes.
Now, this has not happened with any other country athlete.
Yes.
It's only Indians who have been singled out for such a treatment. So, if it was sloppy umpiring, if it was tardy refereeing, if it was incompetence, why does it have to surface only in the case of Indian athletes? Because, then it would be distributed evenly as far as the other athletes are concerned of other countries, but it doesn't happen with those countries. No other athlete, I understand, has complained. It's only the Indian athletes. And the other point here, Gaurav, also is, just if I may complete here,
please.
Other point is that wherever we have raised objections, wherever we have protested, the decisions have been overturned. That means that we were in the right. The umpires also knew we were in the right, but we had to protest vociferously. And then only the umpire reversed the...
But this also shows the mettle of New India and the mindset, Nitin, of our sportspersons. Neeraj Chopra still won gold. Jyoti Yaraji, she stood her ground. It just shows this is New India.
Well, certainly, if you look at the conversation with Neeraj Chopra, when I spoke to him yesterday when he got the gold medal, I asked him very categorically, Neeraj, that how do you look at your, your first throw and which was not counted? He said, I was really surprised. It was weird because at this kind of international level, you cannot expect, from the official that you are not going to count my throw. It may be my best throw, which could have won me the medal. But again, he said, I cannot really do it. I cannot really help it because the officials asked me to throw again. And now I have won the medal, so I am happy. But again, someone likes of Neeraj Chopra Kishore Jena, who has worked really hard, to compete here at the international level to get the medal for your country, give some kind of, the hard work. And officials are just taking it very lightly, and especially against Indian athletes, which is something very, surprising. Because everyone here is participating for the nation.
Absolutely. And China's not playing fair and square, Ambassador Sajjan Har. China's not playing fair and square. What are India's options? Especially the fact that China's playing this mischief in full public glare.
Yeah, absolutely. I think, as you have spoken to the president of the Athletic Federation of India, and they have said that they are going to take it up very strongly, with all the concerned agencies and quarters, and, bring it to their attention. And definitely as far as the role of the Chinese umpires and referees is concerned, but also in a broader principle, what you raised, the question that you raised about denial of visas to Indian wushu players, what this gentleman was saying, that, even USA, they couldn't go, Europe, they couldn't go. I don't think that denial could have been on political grounds.
Okay.
Here, I think we have to be mindful of the reason for which the visas were not given to our athletes. It is political. Mixing politics with the sports is just not on. There it might have been, some delays, some documents have not been furnished or whatever it is.
No, and especially in multi-sport events like either the Asian Games or the Olympics, we'll track the story very, very closely. China better come clean. We will be on the story. Nitin's on Ground Zero, and Nitin Srivastava has been doing a stellar job from China. Ambassador Sajjan Har and Nitin, for joining me here on India First. Many thanks.